We have all had our experiences with pain, especially in the year 2020. However, it is what we do with it that makes all the difference. Some of us drink it away, run up our credit cards, or make a drastic change in our appearances. Throughout life, we all must decide between pain and purpose. I've had this one repeat offender that has changed my life forever. I could still taste the sweat resting above my lip, my heartbeat dancing across my chest as cramps festered in my belly. Did I eat something bad for lunch, I thought? I had this looming urge to vomit, but an unsettling fatigue wouldn't allow me to stand up. I carried my failing body to the bathroom, where I was met with the biggest tragedy of my life at that time. It was my period. What I thought would look like a red dot was more like a small valley of berries, blackberries, that is. I was mortified to the point that I started to vomit uncontrollably. All the lessons I had been taught, none of them prepared me for this phase of growing up. No one gave me the first period talk. I had no products, and what's worse, I had no clue what to do. As the pain enveloped my body, I took a cloud of toilet tissue and started folding it and folding it again and again. I folded it to take the pain away. I folded it to find some understanding. I folded it to collect some comfort. This is what I call the origami of pain. I folded it into the shape of my underwear and placed it between my legs. Pulled up my courage along with my soiled skirt. It was black, so no one knew or saw the bloodstains dancing down the back of it. As I walked back to class, I knew I would never be the same again. It took me 18 long, painful years to be diagnosed with endometriosis and later adenomyosis. I had been hospitalized and seen by doctors more than 100 times, prescribed thousands of pills, slept in the back of my car to drive away the pain, missed countless meetings and events, absent from far too many classroom seats, but most troubling of all, a stranger to my own body for nearly 20 years. And at the age of 31, I had a hysterectomy after years of trauma and misinformation. I now walk with incisions and scars permanently engraved on my belly. Such a surreal experience, as if I had been the star of a new sitcom, The Young and the Wombless. Nothing can prepare you for a hysterectomy. And no one can prepare you for the depression that sleeps with you after. I had become so familiar with feeling my pain at full strength that after my surgery, I did not take any pain medicine. I wanted to recognize my pain, look it in the face, so that when I defeated it, when I folded it, I understood it. Because on that operating table, I lost more than a body part. I lost pieces of me I didn't know anyone could take. And what I got instead was a depression that no doctor's note or prescription could write away. I had stopped attending my own life and became spiritually bankrupt when I knew I was losing my uterus. I was sitting at the porch of pain with no one to talk to about the loss of my femininity. So I started to write and create and discovered the power in my pain, the purpose to help as many women as I could. I knew I had to find a way to transition this pain to power, to purpose. And that was through helping other females by starting my own company called Turning Tulips. It really saved my life. Although this painful experience changed my life forever, I am still one of the lucky ones. For women and girls living in India or Africa, simply getting your period is condemned. Females are literally forced into period huts, marginalized, ostracized, seen as dirty and unworthy. Why? Because their body is performing a natural function? A uterus shedding? Natural. A female on her period? Natural. But there, she cannot touch food. That's unnatural. Or eat at the dinner table. Again, unnatural. Or touch a family member. That's unnatural. She must bleed alone in a hut with no windows, no ventilation, no protection from stray animals or stray men. She may die there because many have. And for others living in poor conditions, they cannot afford feminine hygiene products. So they fold up leaves again and again, and they fold up old t-shirts again and again. Again, the origami of pain. Did you know that 1 in 5 girls right here in the United States will miss school or leave early due to period pain or a lack of period products? Yes, that's right. 130 million girls are out of school due to their periods. It's time to fix that. It's time to take the pain from society, the pain from stigma, the pain from shame, and fold it into a new way of thinking, of normalization, of radical education. This is for every female who's had their period in the bathroom stall, at the mall, while swimming, on a first date, at a sleepover, while camping with her dad, at war, in a car, on the school bus, at work, or simply sleeping in bed. I see you because I am you. And no, not every pain comes from a period or cramps. This message is for everyone. Take your pain on a date. Ask it 21 questions. Find out why it showed up, why it chose you. Figure out the why so that you can find your power and your purpose. Don't let pain hold you hostage. Don't surrender. Have dinner with your pain. Truly get to know it. It took me nearly 20 years to arrive at a hysterectomy, and then another year to heal just enough to have the courage to fold my pain and form a business to help others. Give yourself time. If you experience 5 years of pain, you may need 5 more years to heal. It's your own equation. The truth lies in holding both the pain and the power in your hands. But have compassion for your pain. Get to know it on a first name basis, because I now have a PhD in pain. Find out what essential oil you can rub on your pain. I treat all my pain like a bad period. Give me a heating pad, some tea, and chocolate, and I will figure it out. Now, I want you to take a moment and close your eyes and think about a bad or painful experience. Now, stay with that feeling. We all have something or someone that brings us pain and prevents us from becoming what it is that we wanted and needed to be. Now let's discuss the origami of your pain. Stay with that feeling. Let's see how we can change it and fold it and mold it to become something different, something powerful, something permanent, something positive. And I want you all to take out a piece of paper and write down on the edge of the paper something that brings you pain. But in the inside, right in the middle of your paper, write something that brings you joy or purpose, like love, and then fold it up. Just fold the edges of your pain, tuck that negative part inside, and let's focus on the middle, the part that has all the good stuff, and let that become your new focus, your new energy. Now that we know what pain is, think of it as a partnership. And when it comes again, because it will, you will be prepared to prosper from it and grow from it. Remember to thank your pain. Don't be sorry for it. It's a lesson. How many of you have ever called pain on the phone, picked up the phone and dialed its number? Are you ready to find out why it showed up and for how long? Give it a 30 days notice to vacate the premises of your body, your heart, your mind, and then pick everything else up that's left and go out there and find your power, your purpose, and use that pain as your fuel. Because pain may show up as a nightmare, but it's up to you to fold it into a dream. My pain didn't happen to me, it happened for me to tell my story, for me to help as many people as I can, and for me to make a change. Whether pain comes dressed as your first love, or pain from a period, fold it up again and again and use it to win. So, the question is, what will your pain become? Find the origami of your pain.